think it's time we found our way back home.
You wanna sing?
There's so many things you love as you grow. I miss the days when I was just a kid. My fear became my shadow. I saw where it led. Wherever is your heart, I'll come on. Wherever is your heart, I call home. I know your feet may take you far from me, I know. Wherever is your heart, I call.
Thank you.
I saved my fanciest suit for Madison Square Garden. Trying to come out here looking like a mirror ball. Oh, look at you three. We got Monique Ross right here. Colleen King right here in the middle. And Sean T. Ross over on the end. My girls all pulling double duty, playing strings and singing background vocals. No big deal. It's just Madison Square Garden. I'm gonna sing you guys a song I wrote about my wife, Catherine, but it's a little more complicated than that. I don't know if they have this thing called Vacation Bible School here in New York City. I don't reckon that they do. They have that? Sunday school, Awamas, youth group, any of that stuff? Okay, well, I had it in rural Washington State, and when I was a little kid, I went. And there were good things about that, there were bad things about that. You know, but you learn to take the things that can work for you in your life and leave the things that can't. And I remember this lesson that I was given on the last day that I sort of tattooed on my heart. It was a piece of paper with a picture of a boulder on it and a little house on top of it. And it was to color in. And it said, build your house on a rock. And there's a song that went with it, a little Jesus song, like, build your house on a rock. You don't know, it's fine. But I didn't get it, and it wasn't until I was much older and became a big, giant, happy gay. And then, and married my wife and had those two chaotic little kids of mine. That's I realized that I had done it. I had built my house on a rock. And I knew that it wasn't exactly what Vacation Bible School had in mind for me. A little bit of a different version, but I do think it's what God had in mind for me, and I wrote this song about it. It happens here, so I'll send this out to Pat. It's called You and Me on the Rock. Sing it, yeah! Thank you. First time I walked out on this stage, I promptly started to cry. Any of you guys remember that? My first and hopefully last time crying on stage. Other than with Joni at Newport, that doesn't count. Everybody cry. But it's a sacred stage, and I think to me it feels and it felt like a sacred achievement. And then you achieve it and you're like, maybe I'll never get to do it again, you know? Maybe that was the time. But then you do get to do it again. And it feels like more powerful somehow, because it doesn't feel like a fluke, you know? You come to New York City as a young person to see what you're made of. The city tells you what you're made of. It quite literally does that while you're here. And I think every young person in America at some point should make the pilgrimage to New York City to figure out what they're made of. There's never been a time that we rolled into this city and didn't play this song. And we're going to play it again right now. Tonight I'm going to send it out to Ali Amato. Thank you so much for looking after the Looking Out Foundation and through them, children in conflict and war child. Thanks, Ali. All right, New York City.
Tell you the story of the light. Only if you're sturdy soul. And there ain't no shame in lying down in the bed you made. Can you fight the urge to run for another day? You might make it further if you learn to stay.
And it's a wonderful thing, but we don't fully understand. I can tell you that I wrote this song because it's my mantra, that there was a way to find my own way into motherhood. And that it might not be a traditional way, just like every other damn thing in my life. We just want the right to screw up our kids like all these great people do. This song for, I was thinking about this the other night because I was at John Prine's birthday party at the Lane, which was also kind of a long goodbye. And the first person I ever played this song for, I sat knee to knee with John and I played him this song. It was because I knew he got it, I knew he would get what I was saying. And the reason why is because one time I was going to be singing Angel from Montgomery with John Prine. And I dropped my baby on the floor on a cruise ship. You can't make that up. And I was curling my hair, and she rolled off the bed, and she smashed her mouth open with a pacifier in it. There's blood everywhere. And don't worry, if you have a baby, and they fall, and there's blood everywhere, don't worry, it's probably just the tiniest microscopic cut. You're gonna panic. And I was horrified, and I picked the baby up. You know, we hit one of those damn waves, and she just rolled off the bed. And I gave her back to my wife, and I ran downstairs to where the theater was on the cruise ship. Already, this is sounding like my life. I'm like a human casino. I'm like a living slot machine. So I like run down to this theater to sing with John Prine, and I'm so excited because I'm gonna sing "Fucking Angel" from Montgomery next to John Prine, and I get there just in time to stand next to him in the dark before they announce our names, and I'm just going. And he goes, "Sweetheart, what's wrong?" And I said, "I dropped the baby." And he didn't even miss a beat. This is how cool he was. He goes, "Won't be the last time." I'm gonna play it every day of my life until I get it through my head. It's called The Mother. Welcome to the end of being alone inside your mind. You take it to another, and you worry all the time. You always knew the melody, but you never heard it rhyme. She's fair and she is quiet, but she doesn't look like me. She made me love the morning, she's a holiday at sea. Outside of my windows are the mountains and the snow. I hold you while you're sleeping and I wish that I could go. All my rowdy friends are out accomplishing their dreams, but I am the mother of Evangeline. And they still we
Thank you.
doing here? And shit. And just sing one to the top of the room. added songs to the set list because I can't bear the thought of it
being over ever.
When the fire inside that burns so bright begins to grow faded, it can be hard to see the room on which you stand. Though you may not be afraid, awoken in the darkness, you will feel like a stranger in this land. You can try to carve a place out of your own, but a broken spirit may drive out the bone, and the edges of the night may cause you sorrow. You know I may not be around this time tomorrow, but I'll always be with you.
Thank you.
too late. Either way, I lose you in me someday. Let's do the big one. It wasn't right. That's what the New York City said. I see what you made of.
Yeah.
Can I just say that Brittany Howard is the coolest musician making music in the world right now? Just absolutely incredible, one of a kind, voice of our generation. I have so much respect for her. I called her up when I found out I might get to play this place again. I said, Brittany, it's time for us to play a show together, girl. And she's like, all right, where? It's like, it's gotta be Madison Square Garden, man. How many times can I say that in one night? I wanna introduce my band. Starting with this guy on percussion. But I know you cannot take your eyes off because I'm so captivated by him using my joy bomb. Man playing percussion and hanging out with us and bringing us all his joy and love. Mr. Jeff Hayes in the percussion. On the piano, his first time at MSG. Do not tell Elton John. This is my favorite piano player, Mr. Phil. Is me and the twins' hero. From the time we learned how to play guitar, from the time we became a band, we heard this man's drums in our heads before we ever even met him, because he's a legend, and he's so important to us in our city. He's the great Matt Chamberlain. It took us all a long time to get him in the band, but we finally did. Look at us now, playing for Matt fucking Chamberlain! And I'm sorry, can we just talk about this string quartet over here that sounds like just in town. These guys created these arrangements. They are music directing themselves. They're learning the harmonies. They're keeping us all in line. They're the real musicians on this stage. Right in the front here, on cello, from our very first time we ever played New York City, the OG cellist, the incredible, impeccable Mr. Josh Newman. Right behind him is our queen. She's our MD. She creates a lot of the arrangements that you're going to hear and that you've been hearing tonight. We can't do this without her, Miss Kylene King. And then these two troublemakers on the end. For their first time at MSG, their mama came to town to hear them play this show. I'm Belinda Carlisle, and this is the last night of our tour, and the greatest night of our tour. Aren't you bored with your quiet voice, an impeccable style? Don't ever let them steal your joy. them from running wild. Look at all these beautiful people, man. All these people with a sense of purpose and love. I'll never forget this night.
Yeah.
kind of shit I see on Harry Styles' Instagram. Oh, that makes me feel really special, y'all. Thank you. Beautiful. Oh. You know, so many amazing things have happened to me this summer. This tour has just been the greatest experience of my life. Tonight being the greatest night of the tour, in my opinion. It even rivals what it felt like to sit shotgun and watch Joni Mitchell come back to the stage in Newport Folk Festival in July. That was crazy. That was like watching the seas part. I'll never forget the way that she opened her mouth and just flew. You know, I started singing again. And I called her before I came out on stage tonight and showed her my outfit. Which she really, really liked, said she wanted one. And she's 79 years old, so I don't know what that says about me, but I'm here for it. You can't come out onto a sacred stage like this in a year like this and not honor the great Joni Mitchell, so that's what we're gonna do right now. I've been waiting to sing this song here since I learned it.
Oh,
my best friends and my sister. Mr. Al, Mrs. Allison Russell. Mr. Allison Russell. Get up here, Al. Oh, that ain't no mister. We've been touring together a lot this summer. We recorded this song together. It was just too special of a night for Allie to miss it, so we asked her to come out, and she came all the way out here just for this. Like it's no big deal or something. Yeah, right?
I think we've all been transported. I think our molecules have been rearranged. This is my first time setting foot in this legendary place, and I cannot think of a more legendary show to attend than this one. Randy Carlisle, everybody. I think that Randy, the best way that I can describe her, when I have to describe her, I say that she is already a good future ancestor, because she has left this world immeasurably better than she found it already. She's changed my life and my family's life and countless, countless families' lives. And, you know, this election is coming up, and I think about the fact that families like Brandy's are under attack. We can't let it pass, right? We can't backslide any further. Randy was gracious enough to record this song with me, and we decided to donate all of the Bandcamp proceeds to the Looking Out Foundation's Every Town for Gun Safety Fund. And the campaign for reproductive justice, bodily autonomy, and basic human rights. We are not alone. We are not what we've lost. We are more than the sum of our scars. We are the dust of the stars. And we lift each other up. We are the beloved community. Every time we choose to be, this is real. What y'all have built, this is real. How great you are.
Oh,
incredible adversity, some of the most difficult times that the globe has ever seen. You've always been kind to me. This is my love song to you, and my thank you for everything sweet that you've given me in this band tonight. We will never forget it! Ever! And you know what? We might even get to do it again someday. This is my love song and my wish for you.
Somewhere Mm-hmm.